it's on to mounting, okay? And when you're mounting a horse using the Jeffery method, it's very important to remember to do both sides equally, and actually probably to do both sides, the one that seems a little bit harder, you need to do a little bit more work on. The idea is to get both sides reacting just the same, which is calmly and understanding. The first thing that you're doing when you got your horse and you're using the Jeffery method to mount is to give him a great deal. Now Rio is, of course, he's very, very, very little. He's not got a whole lot of worry about me being around him or anything like that. He thinks it's supper time. So now when you're mounting your horse, it's important to make sure that you've got a lot of relaxation out of your horse. The important parts to understand, important parts to understand and feel are going to be the withers. They're going to be the back, right along the top line. This muscle, Xenophon referred to it as a double spine. It's, in other words, it's two strips of muscle that run straight down the spine. Okay? You're going to want to feel those. You're going to want to make sure that those two pieces of muscle start to relax. At first, they're going to feel like iron beams. Okay? So that's going to be kind of what you're wanting to take care of and make sure that everything's okay with. You're going to want to keep an eye on your horse's ears, on your horse's eyes. They're going to bug out a little bit white, okay, when you first start doing this because it's totally new to them. They totally don't understand what's going on. And so you're going to want to make sure that you keep an eye on that, okay? You want to see that tail. You want to see it swishing. You're going to want to see it aggravated, okay? You're going to want to make sure to keep an eye out for all of those signs, the swishing, the moving. You're going to want to make sure that your horse's lips, you're going to see them pursed, okay? They're not going to be easily parted like Rio says here when you tickle his lip, okay? You're going to want to keep an eye on licking and chewing just like that, because that's going to be a sign that he starts to understand. Now, I usually prefer, if I'm working with a horse that I know has never been worked with before, I usually prefer to keep a rope halter on him and to keep it right along their back right here, okay? And I want to keep that rope halter within reach of me, so that I can keep a hold of that head. When it starts to move away, I can tip it, okay? Now the important thing here is gonna be to jump up and down. And that's what we start next. The first thing you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna start off with a lot of rubbing and a lot of desensitizing. And in the first parts of the preparatory parts where you get your horse faced up, you do a lot of this hand desensitization. You do a lot of this hand desensitization right up in here, in the small pockets right above the eyes. You're gonna go down here into these pockets right here underneath of the nose. These are all endorphin zones for horses. If you can get a horse to let you actually cover his eye and rub and relax it, you're doing really good, because those are obviously spots where a horse would feel like, oh no, get away from me. You know, rubbing around the ears, you know, being able to rub the ears nicely. Rubbing the throat area, okay? You're gonna wanna slowly desensitize a horse to this, okay? And that process is long and involved, and this is a little more about the mounting side of things. So we're kind of getting the cart before the horse, if you will, but this is more an explanation of the mounting, okay? The first thing that you're gonna wanna do is place a hand on the wither. You're gonna wanna obviously bring up that throat latch to where you can get a hold of him and turn him if you need to, if he starts wigging out. The next thing you're going to do is put your hand right over here on the rump. Lots of petting, lots of rubbing, lots of reassurance. You're going to want to stand right here at the shoulder, okay? There's two reasons for that. If you're standing at the shoulder, a horse can very, very easily, if you're standing back too far, reach up, cow kick you, take out your knee, end your whole training session right there unpleasantly. If you're standing up here at the shoulder, when a horse comes towards you, you've got your hands in on a very broad piece of him, okay? You got a really good contact, and you're right at the pivot point, so instead of pivoting him away, or smack into you if you're too far forward, or pivoting him way away where he can really just turn and slam into you with his shoulder, you're keeping him right there. Remember, this is just like riding a bull. If you're right here, he cannot hurt you. It's when you get out into pawing and striking distance. So if you get in a really tough spot and the horse starts getting on you and starts climbing on you and climbing in your lap because you haven't done the face up properly, right here is the best place to be until the horse decides he can get away from you, okay? If it's trample or get on his back, I'm on his back. Hopefully you do your groundwork properly to begin with. That doesn't happen. So the first thing I'm going to do is start jumping up and down right next to him. And he's going to pay attention to this. And when Rio first did this, see, he's like, hey, what are you doing there? He's going to pay attention to that right like that. Now, hopefully, you've got such a horse that's been born broke that that's all he does, okay? But if you don't and he starts to move off from you, you keep with him. If he starts to move off aggressively, you come back on that rope and pull his head around. Pull his head around and bring him back into that face up and go back to face up, okay? And get back over there and walk back slowly down the neck, keeping those legs intact. Bringing that rope up and over, okay? Bringing it around, rubbing the neck, a lot of that. If he gets bothered by it, that's where you go. Next thing you're gonna wanna do is obviously, you're eventually, once that's all fine and he's all settled with that, we're gonna bring Rio back over here, get him a little where y'all can see him a little better, is I'm going to want to mount straight across him, okay? The first thing I'm gonna do, mount right like this. I'm going to rub, rub, rub. I'll show you what that looks like from the other side. Ooh, son. Ooh. From the other side, it looks just like this. Get up and over. Rub, rub, rub. Okay? Rub that hindquarters. Rub that neck. If he stands still for a few seconds, that's all you need. Rub, 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 get right on off. Go back to petting. Lots of rubbing, lots of reassurance. You want these horses to know that that's the right thing to do. The next thing